So, welcome to the world premiere of an Emily Dickinson Sense Around. You're hearing and smelling and tasting something that nobody else has ever experienced before, except for baby Emily Dickinson. So we're going to introduce you to, please come in, we're going to introduce you to perhaps a different take on Emily Dickinson than you had before, we hope so, through your senses, touch, smell, taste, feel, I don't know what else here, with four artists. So first I want to thank artstar.com, who gave us this lovely space, and to our co-sponsor, the Emily Dickinson International Society, and to Lipgraw for existing, one of the most amazing organizations ever. So, my name is Aoife Murray, and I get to be here live from San Francisco because I wrote a book called Made as Muse, How Servants Changed Emily Dickinson's Life and Language. And I'm going to introduce you to the other members of our crew, mostly in order of appearance. So we're starting in the garden with Martin McDowell, I Dig, Therefore I Am. He comes to us from the Garden State. And Marta wrote a book called Emily Dickinson's Gardens. No surprise. Okay, I'm up second, Writer Baker from San Francisco. And we will be in the kitchen at that point, talking about what happens in the kitchen with all those wonderful things that come out of the garden. And I'm followed by Cindy Dickinson. Any relation? Who is Director of Interpretation and Programming at the Emily Dickinson Museum. And once she plies us with food and drink, or we've maybe already been plied with those things, she will be taking us into the parlor where we will be entertained with the music that Emily Dickinson played and heard from her very own songbooks, played to us and sung to us by David Jovichini, historical musician from New England and California, who's here. We are from far-flung states, far-flung states of mind, and welcome.